Got cotton in the bottom land. It's up and growing, and I got a good stand. My good wife and them kids of mine. Gonna get new shoes come picking time.
This is Johnny Cash, Boyhood Home Restored. Like all the people you met just a few minutes ago from the Netherlands and Ireland, those are Johnny Cash fans. They don't know anything about the colony until they get here, and they're just excited about it, the history. It's the art of Johnny Cash. So when they leave here, they get twice their money's worth, I guess you would say. They didn't expect a lot of this extra history when they get here. Some places the government gave these people the land to come in, but Mr. Dyess said let them work and pay it off, and he actually owned the land. So Mr. Cash came here and got his 20 acres with no money down, and the government financed everything. No, it's just a nice house, but it's the way people lived back in the 30s. The government, when they built the houses, they intended to put plumbing in them and electricity. They put one light in the living room, two wires come into the whole house, no plug-ins or nothing. It was 10 years before the Cashes got electricity out of here. They never had any indoor plumbing, even though you see the sinks and tubs and stuff inside. Where the whole commode was supposed to be in, they never hooked anything up.
Well, he's everything, I guess. The music, the lyrics, just the man, and the guitar, and the storytelling. That's what I really like about him. Like you said, it is a part of history, you know, to see where he grew up and what he felt like his whole life, and you can hear it in his music, his inspiration, just everything about this, just a piece of history.
It just brings a new level to his music to actually experience that personally. And you can almost see the family in the cotton fields, and you can just feel more deeply what he's actually singing. I think for us today, I think all of us at some level, we experience tough times, and we see how this family grew out of those tough times, and I think there's lessons that we can learn from that in terms of persistence and rising up out of struggle, and where it looks like there's no hope, there is hope. You can grow.